All right, thanks for coming, folks. This is an update for the media for Strikeforce Courier, a joint investigation between State Crime Command Criminal Group Squad and Southwestern Metropolitan Region. We've executed a number of search warrants in southwestern Sydney today in response to the 2020 murder of Mejid Hamzy. As a result of this operation today, we've arrested three males, a 30-year-old, a 34-year-old and a 28-year-old. Two of those males are going to be charged with the murder of Mr. Hamzy later today. This is an example of a protracted investigation into a public place shooting, which complements our interdiction strategies around Strikeforce Hawk and enables us to solve these crimes in a reasonable time frame. There's been extensive review of all forms of evidence from the crime scene and subsequent review of evidence. We're very happy with the results today. We're very grateful to our partner agencies, the New South Wales Crime Commission and other agencies that I won't mention, in bringing this matter to a conclusion. And these two men will appear before court later today charged with murder. A third man will be charged with serious drug offences involving supply of prohibited drugs, and he will also appear before a court today. With me today, I've got Detective Superintendent Grant Taylor, the commander of the Criminal Group Squad at State Crime Command, who will give some detail around the arrest phase today. But I'd like to say congratulations to the investigative team and congratulations to all those that assisted in bringing this matter to a head today. I'll hand over to Grant and then we're happy to take any of your questions.
Thank you, Grant Taylor, Detective Superintendent. Today's resolution of Strikeforce Courier is a result of 2 years of secret operations, working in partnership with the New South Wales Crime Commission and a number of other law enforcement agencies. We will be alleging that the murder of Mejid Hamzy was sanctioned at the highest levels of international organised crime. The motivation for this murder today relates to the alleged theft of a large importation of narcotics that entered this country. It will be further alleged that this murder was contracted out to some individuals from those organised crime figures from overseas bases, and obviously Mejid was murdered as a result. His family are very thankful to the police for the tireless efforts over the last number of years, and are happy with today's results. Today's operation used all the specialist resources of the New South Wales Police, also in conjunction with some technical capabilities of the Australian Federal Police that assisted us today. The Criminal Group Squad continues to work on a number of shooting murders and other organised crime network investigations, and I can say that we are making significant headway in a lot of those investigations. So over the next number of months, you'll see further results, and we'll continue to work with Strikeforce Hawk and regional police areas and make some significant arrests in the coming months. Thank you. What I'll say is the murder of Mejid Hamzy, we believe, is not related to a family feud happening in Sydney. However, it is related to organised crime, where those families that are known to the media are involved in. But it specifically relates to narcotics and organised crime. It was the first of a number of murders that the media have been reporting on that you would think was appeared to be linked to that family feud, but this one is not.
The irony is that this ignited the revenge.
Exactly. Yes, it was the first of the murders that were represented over the last number of years that were intrinsically linked in the media with the feud.
Do you believe those following murders were linked to this one? It's just that this first pin that fell wasn't linked to the existing feud. Is that a fair way to put it?
Look, all those murders are ongoing. I don't want to go into the specifics of each of those murders. Suffice to say, they're all intrinsically linked to organised crime in southwest Sydney, and there's a number of organised crime networks involved in those syndicates, and we're working in conjunction with the Homicide Squad and other agencies to make inroads into those murders.
The drugs that were stolen, can you tell us a little bit about that shipment? What was the drug? How big was it? What was it worth?
That'll come out in time, but ultimately what I'll say, it was a very large importation organised by outlaw motorcycle gangs international organised crime, and that happened some time back, and that's about as all I want to say about that at the moment.
Will you say that, or do you allege that it was stolen by Mejid Hamzy, or do you believe that someone erroneously believed it was stolen by Mejid Hamzy?
The latter.
It was a mistake.
No, I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is it's alleged by organised crime figures that he was involved in the theft of that narcotic.
But you haven't established that.
That's all I'll say on that point. Thanks.
You spoke last week about the links between the two men when you made an appeal last week that you were looking for between the murders of Mejid Hamzy and Faraz Abunayda. Do today's arrests progress your investigation to murder that matter at all?
We've identified some links in method of operation and some geographic links in a number of these murders. We're not 100% sure which ones are linked to which one by the same people committing the acts, but this investigation today has furthered the inquiry into a number of other matters. These organised crime groups were dominating southwestern Sydney a year ago. That's no longer the case due to our interdiction strategies and our investigation. So, as Grant just said, we're going to move into a phase now where we're going to have some significant operational success in the coming weeks and months and root this thing out once and for all.
You must have investigated any possible link between Faraz Abunayda and Mejid Hamzy, whether the two of them in tandem were possibly accused of this international syndicate drug rip, and whether that might be why they were targeted by the same group. Is that an investigative pathway?
Well, we're comfortable with what we know around the stolen drug consignment and these murders. That's all we're going to say at this stage.
Faraz Abunayda, is he in any way linked to this drug rip as well?
I don't want to canvass any other people involved.
Mr. Taylor, you mentioned that... You mentioned that it's been a two-year operation with some fairly large secretive components to that. Would you say that you had these two men in the frame for 2 years?
Look, we've known a lot about a lot of people over the last 2 years. How we work with the secret operations side of the house is the criminal groups looks at the long-term covert operation strategies, and we work arm in arm with the Raptor Squad. Raptor Squad do the suppression, and between the two of us, our job is to maintain keeping safety on the streets, and we're working very successfully in that regard.
You said it was a contract killing. What was the contract worth?
I'm not going to say any further about amounts of money or any specifics at this stage.
Are you looking into whether these people overseas were possibly involved in the hit on Bilal or the other members? Are they also somewhat linked?
The organised crime networks that we're investigating are all transnational organised crime. Suffice to say that there is links and tentacles far and wide in regards to the murders that we're investigating.
You recovered the murder weapons?
I don't want to speculate any further about weaponry or specifics. The investigation, even though we've arrested and charged or charging two people, there's a lot of legwork to go, a lot of pieces in the pie, and a lot more search warrants and raids to be done, and over time we'll release further information.
Should people feel safer now that this has happened?
Oh, look, we're very confident with our evidence base in regard to this matter. We're looking at other matters involving a similar group. It's a giant step forward as far as managing these crime types and securing the community safety, and we're very happy with today's events. The hard work starts now, so we've got to prove this thing at court now. So we've got three people in custody, two of which are going to be charged with murder, another person charged last year with the same murder. So it is a good day for the people of New South Wales, but for the criminal group squad and the strike force, the work just begins.
So do police believe that the mastermind is living overseas?
Suffice to say that the individuals who we believe sanctioned this murder are international organised crime figures, currently not in the country.
That's all we'll say about that.
All good?
Okay.
Thanks, gents.
Thanks, folks.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.